गुड मॉर्निंग बॉयज़, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट द सेवंथ चैप्टर ऑफ कोर्स बुक रिकी टिकी टावे। इट इज़ अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग स्टोरी ऑफ अ मोंगूज। रिकी टिकी टावे इज अ यंग मोंगूज हु इज़ वास्ट अवे फ्रॉम हिज फैमिली। ही इज़ रेस्क्यूड बाय एन इंग्लिश बॉय। हिज मदर वॉज अफ्रेड टू कीप अ वाइल्ड एनिमल एट होम, बट हिज फादर कन्विंस हर टू कीप इट एज अ पेट बिकॉज इन देयर गार्डन देर आर सो मेनी स्नेक्स। दे नेम्ड इट अ रिकी टिकी टावे। It is curious and adventurous by nature. After breakfast, it explored the garden. This is the story of the time when India was ruled by Britishers. When the mongoose was exploring the garden, he heard a sorrowful voice. It was Darzi, the tailor bird, and his wife. They both were crying. When he asked the reason, they said that one of his children fell down from the nest and Nag ate him. As he asked who is Nag, he heard a hiss sound and a 5 feet long cobra came out from the bush, who was looking at Rikki Tikki Tavi. He was very proudy. Rikki Tikki had never seen any live cobra before, but his mother let him feed on dead cobras, so he knew that his business is to fight with a live cobra. Cobra in his deep heart somewhere was afraid of Rikki Tikki. As we know, the Nagas, cobras, Nagas and mongoose are enemy. So cobra is also in his deep heart, somewhere afraid. Mongoose told cobra that it was not good to eat a small bird who is out of a nest. As he talking to Nag, he was attacked by his wife Nagina from the back, but he saved himself as Darzi, the bird, warned him. Rikki bit Nagina and injured her. Darzi was attacked by Nag, but he was completely out of his range, so he saved himself. Then after both Nag and Nagina disappeared in grass, Teddy the boy then came in garden to Rikki. Suddenly a karat, very poisonous snake, came out. It could bite Teddy. Rikki again get furious. He jumped on Karat's back and bit Karat. It paralyzed him. Meanwhile, Teddy's parents saw Rikki's brave act. Now Teddy's mother even started love to him. At night when Rikki was on walk, he met Chuchundra, the musk rat. The musk rat's cousin, Chuha, told him that Nag was everywhere in the garden. He told so to Rikki. As Rikki was looking for Chuha, he heard that the Nag and Nagina were talking. They were planning to kill each member of the family by their venomous attack, so that the house be empty and their children, who were supposed to hatch from the egg tomorrow, will get empty house. Then after Nagina went and Nag came in the bathroom, where he drank water from the pot which is filled to bath, and he coiled himself under the pot so that when anyone came, he will beat him. Rikki was there quietly watching over the Nag and thinking where he will attack on Naga's body. As Nag settled down, Rikki jumped and held it just down the Nag's head. Nag tried a lot to save himself, but all his attempts were wasted. As they were fighting, a firing sound came. It was the man who woke up. The man means Teddy's father, who woke up by the noises from the bathroom and shot both the bullet in Nag's fang from the back. Then he picked up Rikki and thanked him. Then Rikki went asleep. Now he has to settle Nagina's. Then he met Darzi to ask where the Nagina was and her eggs. He told that Nagina was on Rabi's hip and the eggs were on the melon bed near the wall. He went there to smash the eggs. Only 3 eggs were left as he heard the Darzi's wife was screaming. She told Ricky that Nagina went to house to kill Teddy and his parents. Ricky smashed the last 2 eggs and hold the 3rd one in his mouth and went there fast. As he reached there, he saw Nagina was there to attack on Teddy. Ricky saw the 3rd egg to Nagina and told her to check the other eggs. Meanwhile, Teddy's father held Teddy and dragged him away from the attack of Nagina. Nagina followed Ricky and at last she went into the rat hole where she and Nag used to live. Ricky held her tail and went down with her. Then after some time, the grass by the mouth of the hole stopped waving. Darzi thought that Nagina had killed Ricky. As she was mournful, the grass quivered again and Ricky came out from the hole. He killed Nagina too. When he got into the house, Teddy's parents loved him and fed him with so many dishes. Now everyone has proud on him, even Ricky himself had. He kept the garden free from the snakes and now no snakes dared to come inside the wall. So this is the summary of the story.